Hello students and welcome back. As you're aware, we are doing the chapter Federalism MCQ or its short questions and answers. I hope aapko mera pehla video pasand aaya hoga. If you have liked it, please do like, subscribe and share to my channel. Isse mujhe motivation milti hai aur main aapke baaki chapters bhi cover karta rahunga. Which one comes under the stateless in India? Isme se kaun si aisi subject hai jo ki stateless ke andar aata hai? To humne padha tha union list, stateless and concurrent list. ऑप्शन हैं करेंसी, पुलिस, कम्युनिकेशन एंड डिफेंस. और इसका आंसर स्टूडेंट्स जो है वो है कि द पुलिस सब्जेक्ट कम्स अंडर द स्टेट लिस्ट. चूज द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट रिगार्डिंग लैंग्वेज पॉलिसी ऑफ द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट. तो हमारी इंडियन गवर्नमेंट की एक लैंग्वेज पॉलिसी है. इन चार ऑप्शन में से कौन सी स्टेटमेंट करेक्ट है? सो स्टूडेंट्स, इसमें से कौन सी करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट है? हिंदी इज अवर नेशनल लैंग्वेज. ये नहीं है. तो हम इस एमसीक्यू के साथ साथ ये भी पढ़ेंगे कि लैंग्वेज पॉलिसी में क्या क्या है. हिंदी इज नॉट अवर नेशनल लैंग्वेज. फर्स्ट थिंग, इट इज़ एन ऑफिशियल लैंग्वेज. कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया डिड नॉट डिक्लेयर एनी लैंग्वेज एज नेशनल लैंग्वेज. ये बिल्कुल ठीक है. तो ये करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट है. बाकी क्या है? सिटीजन्स आर फ्री टू चूज एनी लैंग्वेज एज नेशनल लैंग्वेज. ये भी बिल्कुल गलत है. सिटीजन आर नॉट फ्री टू चूज एनी लैंग्वेज एज नेशनल लैंग्वेज. इंग्लिश इज अवर नेशनल लैंग्वेज. नो, इंग्लिश इज ऑल्सो नॉट अवर नेशनल लैंग्वेज. सो करेक्ट इट. Constitution of India did not declare any language as national language. तो हम पढ़ते हैं language policy. A second test for Indian Federation is the language policy. Our constitution did not give the status of national language to any one language. Hindi was identified as the official language, but Hindi is the mother tongue of only about 40% of Indians. Therefore, there were many safeguards to protect other languages. Besides Hindi, there are 21 other languages recognized as scheduled languages by the Constitution. Which of the following subjects is not included in the union list? तो हमने ये पढ़ लिया है. पुलिस, बैंकिंग, फॉरन अफेयर्स और डिफेंस. तो यूनियन लिस्ट में बैंकिंग, फॉरन अफेयर्स और डिफेंस आता है, पुलिस नहीं आता है. Which of the following is not a feature of federalism? Two or more levels of government, ये तो है इसका feature. Different tiers of government governs the same citizen, ये भी ठीक है. Courts have the power to interpret the constitution, ये भी ठीक है. The center government can order the state government, ये गलत है. So they don't have the authority. Some states were created not on the basis of language, but to recognize differences based on geography, culture or ethnicity or all of the above. And student, इसका answer है geography, culture और ethnicity के base पे कई states बनी हैं. So all of the above. The Constitution of India divided powers between center and states in three lists. Listed the powers of the states and left the undefined powers to the state. Divided powers between center and states in two lists, or specified the powers of the states and left the residuary powers with the center. Students, बड़ा important question है. हमें पता है the Constitution of India divided powers between center and states in three lists: union list, state list, and concurrent list. An independent institution to conduct panchayat and municipal elections in each state is called Central Election Commission, Local Election Commission, or State Election Commission, or none of the above. An answer for this student is, it is called as State Election Commission. Police, trade, commerce, agriculture, etc. are subject included in the union, concurrent, state, or none of the above. Bada easy hai, it is part of the state list. Which of the following governments has two or more levels of federal government, community government, unitary government or coalition government? Answer is very easy. It is federal government. The central government can pass on orders to the provincial or the local government, central government, state government or none of the above. And answer is they can pass on orders to the provincial or local government. Education, forest, trade unions, marriage, etc. are subjects which are included in the state list, concurrent list, union list, or none of the above. And answer is they are included in the concurrent list. New states were created in India to ensure proper safety of the people, ensure proper rule, ensure that people who spoke the same language lived in the same state, or none of the above. And answer is new states were created in India to ensure that people spoke the same language, lived in the same state. Federal power sharing in India needs another tier of government below that of the state governments. It is called state offices, local government, district government or tehsils. Answer is, it is called as local government. Which of the following is not a subject of the union list? Banking, currency, law and order or foreign affairs? Answer is, law and order is not the subject of the union list. When power is taken away from central and state governments and given to local government, it is called as distribution, reorganization, centralization or decentralization. An answer for the students is, it is called as decentralization. Tum padhenge book mein bhi likha hua hai. When power is taken away from the central and state governments and given to local government, it is called as decentralization. The basic idea behind decentralization is that there are large number of problems and issues which are best settled at the local level. Which language was recognized as the national language by the Constitution of India? Tamil, English, Hindi or none of these? So it's a very important question. Aapko pata hai, humne pehle bhi refer kiya tha book. There is no national language by the Constitution of India. So none of these. We have Hindi as an official language, but it is not a national language. So none of these. The real success of federalism in India can be attributed to the clearly laid out constitutional provisions, democratic politics in our country, none of the above, or can be both A and B. An answer for the students is, it can be attributed to the democratic politics in our country, you know. My country mein itni badhiya democracy hai, politics hai, it can be attributed. On which given subject can both the union as well as the state government can make laws? Defense, trade unions, agriculture or currency? So students, ye jo MCQ hai, it is basically nothing but asking you to identify the subject of the concurrent list. So answer is trade union. So we'll refer the book also. Like trade unions, marriage, adoption and succession, both the union as well as the state governments can make laws on the subjects mentioned in this list. These lists are called as concurrent lists. If their laws conflict with each other, the law made by the union government will prevail. So union government ka prevail karega. And students, this was the last question for the part 2. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have, please do like, subscribe and share. And I wish you all the success and good luck for the future in life. And after this, I will be publishing the part 3, part 4 and part 5 on the same chapter very soon. Thank you for watching. Have a lovely day.